I don't think we played here since 2019. I don't think you were there then, thank you very much. And this is it sounds like many of you were. And if you weren't, well, welcome. Consider this next song a bit of a reintroduction. It's from that last one. Kind of thing. very last minute. We were Mac was nice enough to let us record for a few days at his studio, and honestly, like my pitch was just like, the night before I started messing with this tune that eventually became this one, but it was like, dude, I mean, you know, they love you in Mexico. They never heard you sing in Spanish, and we both love Vamos a la Playa, so let's write something like that. No, he's not in Chicago, unfortunately, not tonight. Thanks for coming anyway. Will we fund tickets in? Live, yeah, I gotta tell you. So we'll while we're on this kind of robo-doobie tip, there is a song from the first record that I think would actually pair well with this. You might know it, and if you do, feel free to, you know, chime in. Ultimate deal. And it was a real cool hoop one too. You guys would have loved it. It's funny actually, we were trying to figure out how to cover that. It's weird, when you write a record not really thinking about how you're gonna perform it live, you kind of become like a cover band of your own songs. And I kind of, because this record was mostly made on Casio, so we thought we would just like Casio-fy Deadbeat Summer. And I used to hate when bands, like, perform a song from like they, you know, they wrote 20, 30 years prior, and it's like they have to update it, and it's just all, they're so bored with the song, they're throwing in all these like fucked up inversions, and it's all jazzy and terrible. So I'm just saying, if you didn't like that version of Deadbeat Summer, wait another 10 years, dude. I'm just gonna be up here on a stool with like a fucking nylon string guitar, and it's gonna be the worst thing you've ever heard. Anyway, back to the new stuff.
Yeah.
strong. We should stick. We should stay in this trajectory. This next one is from the last record. Yeah. so for this, thank you so much, by the way. For this next number, could we get a little, just a blue ambiance going here? You know, things are gonna get a little bluer, a little slower. That doesn't mean it's time to get a drink. It means it's time to engage.
Love you, Alvin!
Love you, Alvin! And we love you! Thank you so much.
Thank you.
song. That's an icebreaker right there. This next song is about getting broken up with at a restaurant when you did not know that's what you were meeting up to do. So if you're ever in Bushwick in Brooklyn, there's a really great spot called Otis, and the Branzino is amazing, but I couldn't taste it through the tears, so, you know. Question recently that was what do you do to get over a breakup, and honestly a very sincere answer to that would be write a song, and I encourage you to do the same. Yeah, yeah. So, I know, I mean, a pep talk moment, but, you know, clearly we're not on the same wavelength. God. I get it. All right, start the next one before I just keep yapping. So this next song is in French. First song I've written in French, and if you happen to know French, you should sing along because you probably, or most definitely, know more than I do. It started with Duolingo and it ended with a French friend helping to piece it all together, so. Thank you. So this next one's supposed to be our last song, but I wouldn't lie to you. I think instead what we should do is, based on this mutual admiration that we got going on, we're gonna play this tune, and then I'm gonna go put on my belt. And then we'll have an encore, we'll play a couple more.
Yeah.
support. Speaking of which, we want to thank Love for joining us on this second half of the tour. They're amazing. And that means the world to me. Thank you guys so much. I promise it won't be another 8 years before the next record. It'll be 16 years. I'm joking with the band when we're recording, I was like, by the time I deliver this to the label, it's gonna be like the end of Interstellar, like everyone's died, it's a whole new generation of people working there, like the label head's just an AI bot version of himself.
I'll be there.
Thank you. Well, I'll be a little older, a little wiser, hopefully. All right, so this next one is gonna be our last song. It's not bad news. It means there's still another song left in the set, so we gotta make this one fucking count. And I think you know which one it's gonna be because, you know, your biggest song, it's like a marriage. You're kind of in it for the long haul. So.